Let's look at the answer for our cash line size quiz. We are asked to determine which of these are not good line sizes for a 2 kilobyte cache. A 1 byte line is not a good one because it doesn't exploit spatial locality and because word-sized accesses will need to access multiple blocks or multiple lines in the cache. So this is definitely not a good size. 32 bytes is a good size. It exploits spatial locality, it's not too large, and it's a power of 2, so we can easily locate blocks. If I give you an address, you can easily find what block does it belong to. 48 bytes is a good size as far as it's not too large or too small, but it's not a power of 2. So if we are given an address and we need to find out what is the block that contains that address, we need to divide by 48, which is much more complicated than dividing by a power of 2. For example, for a 32 byte size, the lowest 5 bits of the address tell us where we are within the block. This is kind of telling us where within the 32 bytes of the block we are. And the upper bits of the address basically are the block number. So we divide by 32 simply by discarding the lowermost 32 bytes. In contrast, dividing by 48 bytes would actually need to be a division by 48. So this is not a good line size. 64 bytes is also a reasonable block size. It's larger than 32, but still a lot of them fit in a 2 kilobyte cache. 1 kilobyte is good because it's a power of 2, but only 2 of them fit in a 2 kilobyte cache. So this is not a good line size because it is too large, given that the cache is only 2 kilobytes in size. What we want to have as a block size is something that is a power of 2, exploits spatial locality, but still a significant number of them fit in our cache.